What's good, YouTube? You're now tuning in to the Infamous World Network, and you're listening to your host, the Infamous Jerez. For today's episode, we're gonna have another sneaker review. We're gonna be getting into the Air Jordan 6 Carbine. But before we do that, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Make sure to thumbs up for me. The like goes a long way for the algorithm, helps my channel grow a lot. Make sure to subscribe, all the subscribers help. And make sure to comment and say what's up or tell me what's wrong with the video or what you like. I'm always in the comments, I'm really active. So comment and show some love. And last but not least, make sure to finesse the bell. If you ring the bell, you'll get a notification every time I upload, so you'll be able to watch my video as soon as it comes out, so you can put it in your watch later or something nice like that. But without further ado, let's get right into this sneaker review.
And then I'll grab this a little bit into the video.
I could toss it to you if you want some dramatic effect.
Nah, that'd be like, too yo. Much.
And the two fucking, a couple of takes we'll have to try.
Yeah, nah, that shit could get ugly. The Air Jordan 6 Carmine, it released February 13th of 2021. This shoe came out for $200. This shoe, as soon as I seen pictures on the internet release of this shoe, I had circled it and I already started saving up my money. The Air Jordan 6 Carmine is one of my top 10 favorite shoes of all time. The Air Jordan 6 is particularly my favorite Air Jordan silhouette, and the Carmine colorway is one of the best Air Jordan 6 colorways. So this shoe holds a special place in my heart. I'm not sure about for you guys how much you guys care about this shoe, but this shoe for me, I love this shoe so much. Unfortunately, before this shoe came out, there was a lot of delays and there was also a lot of quality control issues, more than usual with Jordan brand, which was sad to see. A lot of the initial pairs that got released, they had a pink midsole, and that pink midsole was like super noticeable. A lot of stores, when they got their shipments, they had to send their pairs back to Nike because the pink midsole was that bad. What's crazy about so many of the shoes having the pink midsole, when the stores sent all these pairs back with the pink midsoles, it made the shoe kind of hard to get. The shoe went from a regular GR to like not the biggest GR. So I actually missed out hitting on this shoe when it first dropped, which was stupid. So I had to pay just a teeny bit of resale, but that's all right, cause I'ma sit on this shoe and I'ma bust this out crispy and clean when the time comes for it. But this shoe, not only does it have the pink midsoles on a lot of pairs, my pair has white midsoles, thankfully. There's also just, Jordan brand did us wrong. This shoe is built pretty shitty. Like the suede is just decent, like it's nothing crazy. Like, a lot of the leather on the uppers and on the back, the leather is pretty mids. For Jordan brand to release the Air Jordan 6 Carmine, especially with the Nike Air on the back, you would think that they would do their best job to make this shoe what it's supposed to be. And this shoe is supposed to be one of the most iconic Air Jordans, because like the Air Jordan 6 is the first shoe model that Jordan won a championship in. Like, this was the shoe Michael Jordan broke through in. The Air Jordan 6 Carmine is one of the ones that he wore on the basketball court too, so like this shoe is just like so big. For them to allow the quality control to be so bad that the shoe had pink midsoles, that the suede is like, it's just decent, it's not even good, and for the leather to be kind of trash, honestly, that's pretty disturbing, especially for me being such a huge Carmine 6 fan. I still had to cop this shoe because I love this shoe, and even though the quality's bad, I wanted this shoe, so I had to make sure I get it. But enough of bashing the shoe, let's talk more about it. This shoe is a really loud colorway, especially for a Jordan. It has the white and red upper. All of the red parts are suede, and you know, you have the suede all along the side panels and all along the uppers as well. On the back of the shoe, it has the red Nike Air, which is obviously the best part. It gives the biggest nostalgic feel to the shoe. Has the black and red pull tab here. We have a white and black midsole for the main part, white toe cap. The outsole is beautiful. It has the nice blue translucent outsoles. I'm a big fan of the blue translucent outsoles because they last the test of time. It has a nice red Air Jordan Jumpman sign on the bottom with the white as well. The outsole is amazing. The shoe comes with white laces, beautiful white laces with a red lace lock. The red lace lock has a Nike on one side and a Jordan Jumpman on the other side. The lace lock is amazing. It has the red and black Jumpman here. Sneaker patch. On the insole of the shoe, it's black with a white Nike Air, which is amazing. This shoe for me was a must cop. I will forever love this shoe and it will always hold a special place in my heart. I'm not sure how all you guys felt about the shoe or if you guys even had a chance to get a pair, but make sure in the comment box so you know, talk to me. Tell me if you got a pair, if you got it for retail, if you had to pay a little bit of resale for it. If you didn't get a pair, I would definitely recommend you get the pair sooner rather than later, because this shoe is gonna go up in resale price off rip, especially because it has the Nike Air. All of the Jumpman shoes that have a Nike Air, they all go up in price. So make sure to get this shoe while it's under 300 for the most part, because this shoe is gonna climb up in value. I can guarantee you that. Also, make sure to tell me in the comments if you grabbed it or if you didn't. Make sure to tell me if your pair had a pink midsole or if it didn't. Also, make sure to be on the lookout because I'm anticipating a lot of pairs of this shoe that got sent back to Nike to be in the Nike factory outlets and other department stores. I'm expecting a lot of them to have the shoe for a huge discount. There's probably going to be a lot of B grades coming out of this shoe very soon. And then some stores are probably going to have a lot of restocks. So be on the lookout for that. You might be able to come up and get one for retail or come up and get one for under retail at one of the department stores or a Nike factory store. So be on the lookout for that. And make sure to spread the word if you end up coming up on that, so other people can come up as well. Spread love. And without further ado, we're going to wrap this episode up. It's your boy, the infamous Drez, signing out. Everybody have a good day. Prosper.